Mr. Santos, I wanted to your thoughts on a few things. You co-chair the task force of census experts at the American Statistical Association, and you've said in your capacity as co-chair that because its data are foundational to our democracy, commerce, and everyday lives, the nation deserves publicly available indicators to assess the credibility of the final counts. And I appreciate your testimony here today, reinforcing this notion of accountability, transparency, the accuracy of the data, and the importance of bringing in outside experts who can give the public more confidence that the census is being conducted in an accurate fashion. Are you satisfied that the Census Bureau has provided all the data that you and other experts need to assess the quality of the census count?
Frankly, that simply has not occurred. We want very much for there to be more transparency. We've outlined in our document, in our workforce report, the indicators that we know exist and could be easily generated and put out to the public and to researchers so that we could establish for ourselves independently the quality of the census counts. There's no question that there are going to be strengths and blemishes to the census counts. There are in any census. However, this time, because of COVID and all of the challenges that I and others reviewed over the course of our opening statements, we think that there is a severe risk for there to be highly differential quality aspects to the counts across the country.
I want to ask you about two relatively specific components of the data. One is getting these measures, these quality measures, assessed at the census tract level. I'd like you to speak to why that's important. And the second has to do with the non-response follow-up process. And I understand those numbers sometimes can be put inside of the overall percent completion rate at the state level, but it's important to break out the non-response follow-up and understand exactly what's happened with that. So if you could speak to those two particular issues, I'd appreciate it.
Sir, it is, as actually Joe Salvo has indicated, incredibly important to get detailed quality indicators down to the census tract level, because we need to know whether some community census tracts basically are neighborhood level types of indicators. We need to know the extent to which there are real problems, not just knowing the total number of people there, but knowing their makeup so that we can plan for things like schools and fire stations and things of that sort. Not to mention, or not only that, but in terms of political representation, if you have a collection of census tracts that is undercounted, whereas the other, say, suburban census tracts are overcounted, you're going to set up the inequality that an inequity that we've heard throughout this hearing thus far, where individuals end up getting less representation and federal funding than they deserve, while others get more than they deserve.
I appreciate that. And I want to emphasize what you just said, because fundamentally, the census is about giving every person in this country the opportunity to stand up and to be counted. And if you don't have that kind of accuracy at the census tract level, as you just indicated, you can have a situation where the voice of some people and some neighborhoods and some communities is being given more weight than the voices of other communities and other individuals in our country. And so you can perpetuate some of the unfairness and imbalanced distribution of sort of political power and voice across the country that already exists in so many ways. The census ought to be combating that unfairness, making sure that everybody's voice is given equal weight. So I appreciate you emphasizing that. That's why it's so critical, Madam Chair, that the accuracy and transparency and integrity of this process be protected. I appreciate the opportunity to have us address that today in the hearing. And with that, I would yield back.